welded, running. Go wild with the ESAB Ruffian ES150G.
In this video, we cover the five fundamentals of stick welding and feature the Ruffian welding generator.
Start by getting in a comfortable position. Grip the electrode holder in your strong hand. Use your off hand for support and brace your elbows on a support or tuck them into your body. Position your head so that you get a clear view of the weld puddle. To strike an arc, tap the electrode or use a small scratching motion with a slight lift. During arc start, you can hold a slightly longer arc to prevent the electrode from sticking. Once the arc becomes established, reduce the arc length and move forward. Here's what a good arc start looks like in slow motion. To stick weld successfully, you need to control five variables. Current affects penetration and how fast the rod burns. Set current based on electrode diameter, type, and application. Remember that arc length is proportional to voltage. A good arc length is about the diameter of the electrode, and often less. 1/16 to 3/32 of an inch is about right for a 1/8 inch electrode. A longer arc increases voltage, heat, and creates a wider puddle. Too long of an arc creates a violent puddle and excess spatter. The short or tight arc lowers voltage, cools the puddle, and creates a narrower bead. See our setup video for more details on arc force and how it prevents the rod from sticking. Travel speed controls bead width. Move slower to create a wider puddle and move faster to narrow the puddle. The correct travel speed does two things. First, it keeps the electrode on the leading edge of the weld puddle. Second, it creates a weld puddle that is no more than 1.5 to 2 times the electrode diameter. When welding in the flat or horizontal position, drag the electrode at a 5 to 10 degree angle. Here's the proper angle. Note that most beginners tilt the electrode too much. When welding vertical up or overhead, direct the rod straight in or push it at an angle of 10 to 5 degrees. Pushing lets the slag system build a shelf to support the puddle. Note that if you ask 10 welders about manipulation techniques, you'll get 10 different answers. Furthermore, manipulation varies by electrode type, amperage, position, joint configuration, and whether you're making a root, fill, or cap pass. For learning to weld in the flat position, use a straight drag technique. A slight side-to-side or tight circular motion is acceptable, but keep it minimal, especially with a 60-13 electrode. To end the weld, stop and pause before breaking arc. This fills the joint and prevents a crater from forming as the puddle cools. Note that some electrodes require specific techniques, which we cover in separate videos. The Ruffian provides excellent results with all types of electrodes. With a little practice, you'll find the settings and techniques that work for you.